Hiya, and Green Hill Gaming, where I share my passion of video games with the whole wide world. In this live stream, I'll be having my last ride. So sit back, relax, put the kettle on, but as always, and more importantly, enjoy the live stream. So this is the final time I'll be playing Dirt 5 for a very long time, because I want to get rocking and rolling into Demon's Souls. In fact, the long-awaited Demon's Souls live stream is happening later tonight at around, let's say midnight tonight, Irish time that is, so stay tuned for that. But until then, I will in fact be having my last ride with Dirt 5. I really enjoyed Dirt 5, have to say. It was a fresh experience. Hadn't played a real driving game in a very long time. I enjoyed the career, the online, when it worked. I even created my own racetrack on Playgrounds. Arcade is a nice mode to get stuck into. And howdy do to my first and lovely viewer. You are very welcome to Green Hill Gaming. How are you keeping? And I hope you enjoy my last ride with Dirt 5. So I really have been enjoying Dirt 5. I've perfected it, more or less. I got a platinum and I played this game back to front for almost a month now. So
Demon Souls, I am... Matter, El Boca.
Who is it? Chan Middleton. Let me tell you, the long-awaited Demon Souls live stream is happening midnight tonight, Irish time. So hope you're happy with that news, chat. Finally, it's happening. But until then, I want to have one final ride, a last ride with Dirt 5. So chat, how are you keeping?
Good job on platinum.
Oh, thank you, chat. Thank you. It was an easy platinum, to be fair. Here. Damien platinumed Ghost of Tsushima. I know I can't pronounce that. Ghost of Tsushima. He platinumed that. Man, that is what you call an accomplishment when it comes to getting a platinum. Damn. But chat, how are you keeping? And you're very welcome to the live stream. So yes, let the last ride with Dirt 5 commence.
I'm stuck on the third boss of Sonic Mania.
Third boss in Sonic Mania. That wouldn't be the weather boss. That wouldn't be Dr. Robotnik when he's like changing the weather, no? God, it's been a while now since I played Sonic Mania. Ah, you'll get there, Chad, don't worry. So I kick off the live stream with a bit of arcade free play. Well, I got to Brazil, China, Greece, Italy, Morocco,
the helicopter
Norway.
One with rockets.
Oh, that's a tough one, Chad. I bet you it's the last missile that gets you every time, isn't it? Oh god, that's a tough one. Just time your jumps, Chad, is all I can say. You'll get there. South Africa, USA. Let's go to China. And I will go to Lingyihata Hills. 90s rally. It's actually raining very heavy right now here in Ireland, so let's go with heavy rain. Realistic and all. It's currently... midday? It's not quite... well, it's dark outside, so I'm going to go with night. Time speed multiplier 2. 3 laps. Precise 12. Medium difficulty. Start event. I think, seeing as it's my last ride with Dirt 5 for a long time, I mean, I obviously will return to Dirt 5 at some stage, but for now it's my last ride with Dirt 5. This is the final time I'll be playing Dirt 5 for a long time, because Demon's Souls is happening tonight at midnight. So seeing as it is my last ride with Dirt 5, I am going to customize, I'm going to purchase first of all, and then customize a new vehicle. Starting with this Ford Escort R5. We're getting a good chunky live stream in. Gonna Level 65, they're for real. How about no pattern? How'd you like that? So, let's have a look at some textures. What textures can I get? Level 88. Oh, I like this. Pause. That's cute. I like that. Hold on a second now. I thought I put the stove on too soon. Alright, so.
I'm going to get classic Doom with my gold points.
Those gold points are fairly handy, Chad, aren't they? So you can... Geez, I would have thought you would have had classic Doom well by now, Chad. Shame on you. Ah, good stuff, Chad, good stuff. You would have seen a lot of Doom on my channel. Remember all the Doom live streams I used to do?
It's on sale for $3.
Jesus, $3. Can't go wrong there, man. I can't decide which colour. I'll go with black. Then for the main. I think I like that orange actually. I'm gonna go with I like this. I'm gonna go with this. Alright, so that is pretty much wheel color. So this is the final vehicle that I'm going to be customizing in Dirt 5 for a hell of a long time. I like it. Sponsor layout. Sticker. I always put the sticker on the bonnet in the front. Got new stickers I can use. I didn't really reach a high level, did I? I'll go with this. Whatever that is supposed to be honest. Costume, man. Let's put it down here. Make it a bit bigger. There we go. Sorted. Sorted. Okay, save and quit. And start the race. You know, so Dirt 5 for me was a very fresh experience. Glad I decided to buy it. Mr. James Hollywood, hello to you. How are you getting on, James? Welcome to Green Hill Gaming. In this live stream, I am having my final ride with Dirt 5. This is going to be the last time I'm going to play Dirt 5.
Sorry, they got a new teaser yesterday.
What is that?
Sup, James.
Resident Evil. Oh, yeah, that's right. There's going to be a massive Resident Evil event next week. I am hyped, to say the least. They're going to show more information on Resident Evil Village.
I'm all good, you.
Glad to hear it, James. Good stuff, man. Good stuff. I am doing well now, James. Thanks for asking. If you're interested, I'm doing a Demon Souls.
Hi, Chad.
Live stream at midnight tonight, if you want to check that out. That should be interesting, to say the least. I'm probably going to pull up what's left of my hair, because that game is supposed to be so difficult. So enjoy the live stream, James. So yeah, Dirt 5 has been a very fresh experience for me now. I'm glad I decided to buy it. You know, it's been a very, very long time since I played a realistic driving game. It's just something different from other games. I mean, I was going, I know I've told the story like 1,000 times already, but I was going to buy Watch Dogs Legion and Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. But fresh experience, something different, something new. And I went with Dirt 5 and Demon's Souls. And I've loved I mean, the visuals will just take us right away. But gameplay-wise, it takes full advantage of the DualSense controller with the adaptive triggers and haptic feedback. So lads, sit back, relax, enjoy my last ride with Dirt 5. It's been fun playing Dirt 5. I hope that you've all enjoyed watching my
I'm
Dirt
sure
5
Watch
live stream.
I'm sure Watchdog will go down on price. It's Ubisoft.
Oh, definitely. It probably already is, to be honest with you. I didn't miss anyone in the live chat, did I? Just looking there. I'm always conscious of that. Nope. So, James, have you been playing any new games? Have you been playing any good games? Anything interesting? I remember on Sega Mega Drive, I had a Formula One racing game. On Nintendo 64, I had a racing game called Lamborghini Challenge, which I really love. I think that's pretty much it, really. So that just goes to show, like, just how long it's been, like, since I could play the racing game, and how little I've played of racing games. I mean, I would have played a few demos of, you know, a few racing games on PS1 and PS2. Oh no, Need for Speed. What am I saying? Need for Speed. I need to see, well, the Underground series on PS2. Oh, what a series the Underground series was. Love that game so much.
Just GTA, really.
GTA? Well, that's a game you're going to be playing under the colonization of Mars, James. If you're living on Mars, James is playing GTA 5. But they're not in a hurry to release GTA 6 anything soon, are they? But as long as you're enjoying it, man, that's all that matters. I know they added in a couple of updates to the online as well, didn't they? There was a massive update there they added in recently to the online. Any games you're looking forward to this year? And you too as well, Ken. And anyone else watching? That's an interactive question. What games are you looking forward to in 2021? For me, it's definitely Resident Evil Village.
And I want to see Red Dead Redemption 2.
Red Dead Redemption 2. Ah, well, that's a good game. From what I've seen of it. Good stuff, man. That's a game that will keep you busy. Yeah, I can't wait to see where the Resident Evil series goes, like where the story goes. Especially with Chris Redfield, like what is going on, like.
The Last of Us 2 Remastered PS5 El Boca.
The hell out of here, chat. The Last of Us Part 2 Remastered in PS5. You know, I said it before and I say it again, I think racing games really showcase...
I heard something about an open world Star Wars game was being talked about.
Oh yeah. Ubisoft are making a new Star Wars game. Is that the one? From the same people that made The Division, I think, isn't it? I did hear something about that yesterday. I thought that EA had the rights to the Star Wars video game franchise, no?
That's Bethesda doing Indiana Jones.
Oh yeah, Bethesda doing Indiana Jones as well. That's Bethesda doing Indiana Jones. You know, I strange hunch that somebody at Bethesda was just watching Indiana Jones movies on TV recently, because they were on TV, I don't know what channel, but they were on, well, it's both
not anymore, Lucas cut ties with EA.
How did they? I'm glad they did, to be honest with you. I'm glad they did. I really am glad they did. George Foley, unlucky. Three people from Ireland. Well, CPU. Ireland anyway.
Thankfully.
Thankfully indeed. Thankfully indeed. What was I going to say? Yeah, Indiana Jones was on TV over the New Year. And I just had a strange hunch that like, somebody at Bethesda said, let's make an Indiana Jones game. Because apparently it's meant to be very early in development. Like, they haven't even started it. Like.
Back for Blood looks really good. It's like Left for Dead 3.
It does seem that, James. Seen that there. When did I see that? The Game Awards. It does, yeah, it looks very interesting, right, to be honest. Looks like a fun experience, a fun multiplayer experience. Let's go to the Redeemer.
Same creator, wasn't it?
It is, really. I'm not sure about that, no, Chad. But possibly. Let's go to morning. Time is it now? Oh, Jesus, I need to pop into the kitchen in a few seconds. Good size, medium. Number of laps. Oh, this is what is this? What event is this? I'm not going to customize another character to take up too much time, but I showcase one of my customized vehicles. So with PS5, I want to try out as many new experiences as I possibly can. I'm going to try to do things differently on PS5. That's why I didn't buy the new Call of Duty and the new Watch Dogs. The way I looked at it, I was never really a Call of Duty fan, was I? I only liked a handful of their games. I never really played most of the multiplayer on Call of Duty. And it has been a hell of a long time since I played, you know, Black Ops, so I didn't know where the story was. So I thought to myself, would I get the most out of Call of Duty Black Ops World War? And the answer to that question was, no, I wouldn't. I just know I wouldn't. So what's the point of, you know, paying for a game and playing it if you know you're not going to get the most out of it? And with Watch Dogs, it's kind of similar. I'm not really into that series. I didn't even play Watch Dogs 2. Well, I did play a little bit, but I didn't own it. Somebody else had it, and I played it a bit of it. That's quite funny, actually. It was their game, and I was playing it, like, the whole time. But I was never really into it, and I just feel like the Watch Dogs region, I don't want to say it's a gimmick, like, but it's the only thing that kind of gets me interested in it, is the fact that you can actually play as anyone. And I think once you kind of remove that, like...
The new Watch Dogs is absolutely amazing.
I agree with you. The news watch... The what? The Callisto Protocol. I've got to pop into the kitchen there for a second. James, it is a good game, but you'd have to kind of... 2 seconds. Not sure that I have... Right. Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, I just felt like I was never really into the series, and I just felt like play as anyone is just one, it's just one part of the game, and I just felt like would I get the most out of the rest of the game, modes and features? And unfortunately, again, the answer to that question was no. So I decided to look at other games, other PS5 games, maybe games I hadn't played before. Or much of, and that's why I looked at a racing game. I thought, boy, I hadn't played a racing game in just a hell of a long time. So I felt it was a fresh experience, and took full advantage of the DualSense controller as well. And with Demon's Souls, I never played, you know, that series before. Like, I mean, I always heard about, you know, Dark Souls. Never played Dark Souls. And
this is sort of a reworked Watch Dogs 2.
A reworked Watch Dogs 2, that's interesting way to put it. But no, I'd say it is a great game. I'm just approaching PS5 much more
Cyberpunk apologize critically. Again after Polish police got involved.
Are you serious? Man, I almost feel sorry for CD Projekt Red at this stage, to be honest. That was a tight first place. Yeah, CD Projekt Red are not in a good place right now, are they? I almost feel sorry for them. So with Demon Souls, yeah, again, fresh experience. I just feel like if I played Call of Duty, it just wouldn't feel fresh. It would just be Johnny playing the latest Call of Duty. You know, a series that he was never really into to begin with. Just because he wanted to see what happens after, you know, Black Ops 1 or Black Ops 2. Don't exactly know where the story takes place. But like, seeing as I haven't played a story of Black Ops in a hell of a long time, like, would it have been worthwhile? And, again, first, the answer to that question was no. You know, And with Watch Dogs then, it was like, you know, Johnny plays Watch Dogs Legion. You know, it's just, is that the main reason to get a game, or just because of, like, you can play it as anyone? And, yeah, it's just really kind of looking at, PS5 games in the sense of, like, will I actually will I get the more sort of that game?
I haven't played Cyberpunk yet. Is it as slagey as people say?
Well, I haven't played it myself, so I can't really comment too much on it, but a lot of people are saying that it's laggy and buggy and glitchy, so I suppose, like, you just kind of have to kind of take their word for it, really, like, you know. But a lot of people are saying the same thing about Watch Dogs.
Yeah, my friend been streaming it.
Oh, there you go. Chad has spoken. Mr. Middleton has spoken. This is my Mario design tab. But yeah, James, there's a load of people online that are having, like, a lot of issues with Cyberpunk, so it's not just one kind of isolated issue, like, you know, it's known for it, like, it's not gonna look terrible, it's terrible as well, like, they put all their focus on the next-gen version, so it's completely abandoned the, you know, PS4 and Xbox One players, But it even still has issues on next gen as well, which is interesting. I would actually encourage every gamer to actually look at the game they're about to buy and really ask themselves the question, will I get the most out of this game? Like, yeah, it's a big game and everyone is talking about it. Yeah, it looks great. Yeah, it sounds great. Everyone is talking about it, it's the next big thing, but you have to kind of ask yourself the question, you know, will you get the most out of that game? And that's what I'm going to do now, going forward with every game on PS5. And that's why I didn't buy the new Call of Duty until you watched that. I felt with Dirt 5, you know, again, I haven't played a racing game, a league racing game for a while, but, you know, I kind of like the idea of getting stuck into a racing game.
Wasn't it realised way earlier than it was meant to?
Is that now? I don't know. I know that it's been in development for like years. It was like, wasn't in development for like 8 years or something. Or even longer. Well, that game was in development for years, man. It even got delayed like 2 or 3 times. So I don't know about being released too soon. I mean, if they released it too soon, I don't know what the fuck they were doing in the last 8 years, like, put it that way. It was in development for years, man.
It's been in development for 8 years and had multiple delays.
Yeah, so like, I'd say it wasn't the fact that the release was too soon. I think it's the fact that it was just completely fucked up. You know what I mean? Like, that's what I would say anyway. And then you have, I want to think of a word to describe them. Rockstar sympathizers? Is that, that's the word I'm going to use, yeah. Then you've got Rockstar sympathizers who are like, don't worry Rockstar, Take your time with GTA 6, even though it's fucking 7 years since fucking GTA 5 came out. Take your time with GTA 6. Just look at Cyberpunk. I mean, that irritates me. Like, I don't even have Cyberpunk. I don't even care about the game, but that's
instead
what pisses
of
me off.
Starting over, they just put band-aids on it.
No, yeah, that's exactly what it is. Exactly what it is, man. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. What the hell, how did they end up with this? Oh man, I went the wrong way, I'm sure. My last ride with Just 5, like, I really haven't played playing this game. I can truthfully say that, it's not. Been playing it since Christmas Day. Completed the career mode. Played a good amount of online as well. Actually, maybe I'll actually finish off by playing online, actually. Yeah, I don't think we should buy games based off hype, based off reviews, based off the fact that it's a...
They are overhyping
game.
GTA 6, I think they're promising way too much.
Who's overhyped? GTA 6 doesn't even... There's nothing to get hyped about. That's the problem, James. Like, GTA 6 doesn't even exist. I don't think it's the fact that people are getting hyped over it. I think it's the fact that people are pissed off because there's nothing on GTA 6. There's only all these insiders and so-called leakers. No, that's absolutely hilarious, no, James? Like, I don't think Rockstar is hyping GTA 6 because they're not even talking about it. You know, I think it's just YouTubers that are hyping GTA 6, basically. You know? You know what irritates me is when you still have people saying, like, you know, Rockstar teases GTA 6. Teases. I mean, 8 years later and people are talking about teases. That is just irritating, like. Oh, don't get me started, Looney, GTA 6. Oh, God,
Luna,
anyone who knows me.
Woke protagonist, El Boca.
Yeah, moving on. Dirt 5. Oh, we found a good few people here. Good few people. You know what I like about Dirt 5 as well? Is the fact that... look for a good vehicle here now. Is the fact that Codemasters... let's go with this. Developed the game. And I have history with Codemasters because I played Micro Machines many years ago on the Sega Mega Drive, and I played again then on PlayStation 1 with Micro Machines V3. So it was really good. No, it was really nice to be able to go back to the Codemasters and play their latest racing game. Dirt 5.
They will have another 5 CODs by the time GTA 6 comes out.
Oh, stop the lights. Stop the lights. Man, we'll have, like, I swear to God, man, we'll be living on Mars by the time GTA 6 comes out. Honestly. But don't get me started. Don't get me started in GTA 6, man, I'm telling you. Please, man. Oh, stop, please don't get me started in GTA 6. I'll be here all night, like, so. I want to go into my Demon Souls live stream. It's happening at midnight. Irish time tonight. With a fresh head. I don't want GTA 6 to be on my mind when I'm playing Demon Souls. Before fitting enough game as it is, I don't need to get any more first build. I swear to God, lads. This game also uses 3D
There's
audio.
There's a GTA 6 thumbnail with a date of February the 8th, El Boca.
What? I couldn't hear that comment, yeah. Let's not talk about GTA 6, terrible guy. Going to say now. This game uses 3D audio as well in a very unique kind of way. I can't really explain it, but when you pass the speakers in the game, that's where the music kind of comes from, like, and it kind of goes all around your ears, like full fiddly, like, to the audio. It's a nice little effect. Obviously it's full 4K visuals, and if you're always racing games, they could advantage of graphics. And it's because, like, they can put that more detail because they're only, like, driving on a small, like, track, you know what I mean? So they don't have to put too much detail. I mean, what I'm saying is they don't have to...
Atari has its last console update this year.
What is that? What? Oh man, I couldn't read it. Terra, is it? Terra. Can somebody complete it by second time? Oh, he's spinning out of control. Second place, buddy. Second place. I'm getting that second place.
Area.
Ah, no, not again. It's getting its final update, isn't it?
Sausage is a thing.
Something sausage? All I have is sausage is a thing. Sausage. As I can't look down, I'm in second place, I've got a maintainer. I don't know, it's not done there. Luigi's sausage. Luigi's sausage is a thing. What the hell? What's that about? See, but the reason is not it. Back to the fourth place. Ah, that's it. Unbelievable.
Luigi has a new sausage cart in Mario Kart 2.
Mario Kart what? I don't think you have a new topic. Ah, you bastard. Fourth place.
It sounds like a porno.
It actually does, to be fair. I'd watch it, like, just say. I'd watch it. Joke, by the way. Joke. Or am I?
You should see the men's.
The men's. Luigi has a new sausage cart in Mario Kart Tour. I played Mario Kart Tour literally once at a train station or a bus station, and that was the last I played it. Mobile game. They don't keep my attention. You know what I mean? I just can't stick to them. You know. I was going to do something, now I forgot what it was. So are you looking forward now to the Demon Souls live stream? Happening midnight tonight. It's midnight Irish time. Like, I don't think I'm actually prepared for, like, how difficult that actually is, you know? Like, I probably have it in my head, like, it's going to be a hard game. Kind of, like, I'm going to be like, oh, yeah, it's hard, whatever, you know? I'm sure I'll handle it. And then, like, I probably won't even be able to, like, figure out, like, what I'm doing. Like, I will take that as a yes. It's probably going to end up being a lot more challenging than I actually kind of, like,
just
in my
struggled
head,
on it.
Think what it is.
Yeah.
Ah, cool, a brule of gems. I'll see you there, man. I'll see you there midnight tonight. Demon Souls. He struggled on it. Oh, dear God. And this is the creator of God of War, like. Not good. Not good. Should be a fun experience nonetheless, though. Johnny's snapping. You like drawing me out, don't you? You bastards.
Hello, everyone.
Who is in the live stream? Dad, welcome to Green Hill Gaming. How are you getting on? How's your day been? You are very welcome to Green Hill Gaming, Dad. I'm having my last ride with Dirt 5 in this live stream, because I'll be moving away from Dirt 5.
You should play it on max difficulty.
Forward. Oh my shit. Max difficulty? That'll kill me, man. This is Mr. Bean's mini as well, by the way. I know Jeff James will know Mr. Bean.
It was on his top 10 games of 2020. All good, thanks. Hi, first
good
time.
Subject. I'm glad to hear it, Dad.
Hello, Johnny Dad.
This is Mr. Bean's car, and it's I didn't get time to show it on properly. Have you ever watched Mr. Bean, Chad? I know that he had a movie, two movies, like, that would have been released in America, so.
Oh wait, I just realized his name was First Time.
No, it's actually Fist Time. That's the funny thing about it, his name is actually Fist Time. I know, random. That's actually funny. James thought his name was... Like, James looked at the name and like, thought that it was First Time, but it actually is Fist Time. Mr. Bean's car anyway, like. Mr. Bean is joyriding around there right now. Oh, this is terribly fast. Actually,
that's
installed.
My
card,
give it back low.
Nah. Unless your name is Mr. Bean, no. It's ain't your car, and you ain't getting it. But I haven't even installed Demon Souls yet, to be honest. I hope it isn't allowed again. Although games do install pretty quickly on PS5, and I have it physically as well, like, so it's not going to be downloaded or anything, so it shouldn't take too long.
Johnny's dad, can I have an autograph? Cat Mario vs Bowser Fury Dynamax.
Wait, hold up a second now. You never ask me for an autograph. Heartbroken, no. Crashing into bridges, no, but you know. Where's my autograph request, huh? Up here. Yeah, that'll be that comment on the second, because that computer voice just... They haven't done that computer voice half the time. Lads, I thought I was driving bad, but that's why and Daniel is having an office that I'm driving right now. So yeah, happy enough now to move on to Demon's Souls tonight, midnight again that time.
Johnny's dad, without him you wouldn't exist.
Well, that's true, but still, again, I'm deeply offended.
We must thank him. John, that will
so
just
you don't want
change.
An autograph off me, so, no?
James want the of Johnny.
James wants the OG Johnny. I think it's the OG Johnny. I think it's the OG Johnny. What's this fucking name? OG Johnny. Jim, would you like some guy that would meet Tom Cruise and ask for the cameraman's autograph and completely ignore Tom Cruise? Can I have the autograph? Oh, sure. No, it wasn't talking to you. It was talking to the cameraman. And he's like, oh, fine. That's what it feels like.
Remind me, never get into a car with you driving low.
Too bad. Let me break down there now in a second. We'll go to GM so you can get your autograph.
Hello.
Oh man, that's not too bad. This is great. Oh, he actually passed me on. Oh, wait. Well, that went kind of well. No. This is quite a lot.
I think I are better at jumping on cars, lol.
What? Oh, God. You still remember that story? Funny story, actually. Friend of mine, mad into cars. Went for a spin one.
Johnny's, may thing. I have your autograph, to please?
Johnny, may I have your autograph? You're asking me now? Johnny, may I have your autograph? Ah, thank you. I feel better now. No, you can fuck off. You can get my autograph. Thank you, Al. I'm not going to harass me. And I'm going to joke with James. Happily give you my autograph. But, yeah, funny story. A friend of mine, man, the car, one night we went for a spin. I ended up on the bonnet of his car. Don't ask. Doesn't that car look like a face at the moment? Basically clinging on to the bonnet and he drives him up to that road. Ah, sometimes.
I want Jonathan Nigel from the UK autograph, El Boca.
Yeah. And we can keep fucking waiting. Jonathan's fucking Nigel. I'll give you Jonathan Nigel, I know, Chad. How can I explain where you are? Just gonna have to head off you. Give it to the OG Johnny then. This, I feel like this is like a pre-show to Demon's Souls live stream.
Were you pissed drunk?
Welcome to... Only on 7-Up. No, I don't even drink yet. He's back in the bollocks. Great time for him. But he's back in the bollocks and he was like pretending to fucking... He was pretending to knock me down. The mental fucker. But he wasn't going fast or anything, you know, he was driving into me. So I just said, fuck it. And I jumped onto the bonnet. And he just like, I was expecting him to drive, but he just kept on driving.
And that is the story.
So lads, this is going to be the final race of the live stream of my final time playing Dirt 5. My last ride with Dirt. This is technically and literally my last ride with Dirt 5. For a long while anyway. For a long while. I've got a lot of games to play. I have Demon's Souls. I still have to officially complete Sackboy Big Adventure, but I'm still waiting for an update to fix my game breaking bug. And speaking of bugs, what a great segue. I have bug snacks. Oh man, what a segue. Sorry, no. I need to get a W in the chat there for that segue. Come on, no legs.
Something similar happened with me and my friend. YouTube buffing.
What the hell? See how he drives, no legs. Lads. I need to know what that story is.
Except it was on a bike, and I ended up fracturing his skull.
Jesus. Well, it reminded me never to get on a bike with you anyway. Jesus. You can't be fracturing his skull. Oh. I'm actually scared just reading that. Funny actually to say that, I actually had a similar experience, but I didn't pass the show. I had his wrestling friend years ago. I thought he was more than just a wrestling friend, but we just kind of became friends through wrestling. And one time he called me, another friend of his, and he's on a bike, and he said, hop on. But I was a pure, like, let me tell you one thing, right? One thing you should know about me when I was a child. I wasn't one
depends
of those...
Depends on what ride you mean, low.
Who the fuck said? I would take you to say that, wouldn't I? Jesus Christ. Anyway, swiftly moving on. I wasn't the most, like... I couldn't cycle a bike until I was 17, but like, that just says it all about the kind of person I was. I wasn't the most outgoing, you know, fucking kid, like, you know? I couldn't even cycle a fucking bike, so I was terrified. Because I jump on the back of the bike, so terrified. I didn't want to. So I was nervous, like, in the back of the bike, like. And I was like, I want to get off. And I don't know, I'm looking distracted at the menu. And he fell off the bike. I didn't push him off, no, he fell off. And he fell onto his face anyway. He had a bad big cut in his face.
What happened was he hooked on the pets on the bike. And we went down a massive hill, and we went down the hill, and I stopped and he went flying. Oh.
Jesus Christ, man. You're just like, what? So you were driving the bike, was it? Or cycling the bike? And you hit the brakes, was it? And he just went flying. I mean, I was the kind of kid like that was side playing Final Fantasy 9, like, you know.
Who thought it was calling to me? Sitting on a bike. Fuck yeah, the bike.
That was basically me, like. I haven't changed much, to be honest.
Yes.
Jesus Christ, yeah. Where did you stop? Are you being chased by a llama? Or a lemur? Oh, what the fuck are things are called? I took your family from Florida.
I also made him infertile because I ran over his balls as well.
Jesus. Are you serious? Damn, I'm scared of you, man. Fucking Trevor Phillips, you're out there from GTFI. Huh? That was a nice fourth place there. I'll take that fourth place. So lads, that's pretty much going to be it for this live stream, my final ride with Dirt 5. Once again, this is the final time that I'll be playing Dirt 5 for very long.
He was begging me to stop.
Oh, he wanted? Well.
Talk about a flying jump low. The fecking lemurs.
What are lemurs, man?
Me and him are still good friends.
Well, that's all that matters. That's the most important thing, really. That didn't quite happen with this guy. He wanted to fight me and everything when I was going at the first show. I don't think he actually showed up. I was there waiting, and he didn't show up. I think that's how it happened anyway. Oh god, fun times. I still see him around and we talk. It's an awkward kind of talk, like, you know, he just knows me as the person that fucking ended up busting his face on the bike. So there you go. At the end of the live stream, my final ride, Dirt 5. I'll be swiftly moving on to Demon Souls from here onwards. The long-awaited Demon Souls live stream once again happening tonight at midnight Irish time. So thank you for watching this live stream and all of my other Dirt 5 live streams. I hope you enjoyed them and I appreciate the support as always. And hopefully I will see you tonight at midnight for my Demon Souls live streams, and hopefully I'll see you in all of my upcoming Demon Souls live streams. So lads, take it easy. It's been interesting, James. Some amazing stories there, man.
You should neuter him with a chopstick.
Oh, fucking hell, man. I love your randomness. Oh, Jesus Christ, man.
Enjoyed.
Oh, fucking hell, man. Well, the next time we'll see him, we will. Glad you enjoyed that, and I hope you all enjoyed. And listen, I will see you next time on Greenhill Gaming tonight.
I will see you later.
Ah, thank you, James. See you there. Hopefully I'll see you all there. Tonight, midnight, Irish time, Demon Souls. Be there or be square. I was going to say something else, but I won't be rude. Jeez, I'm definitely not the OG Johnny if I just said that. Anyway, I'll see you.